Here it is one of the roti. You imagine that it is one of the roti. Okay. Dear student, here it is one of the roti. It has been cut into two parts. It has been cut into two parts. Look at these two parts. Look at these two parts. These two parts are equal in size. Dear students, look at these two parts. These two parts are equal in size. No, these two parts are not equal in size. These two parts are unequal. Here, I take one more roti. Okay, it is again, it has been divided into two parts. Yes. Dear student, I take one more roti. It has been cut into two parts. Also these two parts. Tell me, these two parts are equal in size. Yes. Dear student, these two parts are equal in size. In the above roti, the two parts are unequal. I take one more roti that can be cut into two parts. The two parts are Yes. Each figure. Cut into two equal parts. Here students, each figure cut into two equal parts. One part is shaded in each figure. Dear student, the one part is shaded in each figure. The shaded part we call it as a shaded part is called one half. The shaded part we call it as a one half. It is written as, it is written as one by two. It is written as one by two and read it as one half. One half. Dear student, observe these three figures. The each figure having the two equal parts. In two equal parts, one part is shaded for each figure. The shaded part we call it as a one half. How to return this? How to return? It is written as a one by two. It is a half. Dear student, I draw the two figures. You shaded these two figures of one half. You shade the figures represent one half. How to shade it? Dear student, each figure having two equal parts. The one part is you can shade it that represent one half. Okay? Dear student, figure. It is also having in two equal parts. In two equal parts, one is shaded. One part is shaded. One part is shaded. Therefore, it is also represent 1/2. That is 1/2. It is also 1/2. Okay, this is the identification or learning method of 1/2 or 1/2 fraction. Okay, then we go to the 1/4 or 1/4. Second one. 1/4 and another name 1/4, that is 1/4. 1/4 or 1/4, it is fractionally represented as a 1/4. 1/4. Okay. Dear student, I draw some pictures. So this is one of the circle. It can be cut into 4 equal parts. Okay. I draw one more figure. That is also cut into 4 equal parts. Dear student, also these two figures, each figure having a 4 equal parts. Dear student, I draw the two figures, the each figure having a 4 equal parts. In 4 equal parts, I can shade one part of the each figure. I can shade one part of the each figure. So then we can shade the one part of the each figure. Dear student, I already shaded. I can shade one part of the each figure. That is represents 1/4 or 1/4. Dear student, each figure have 4 equal parts. How many equal parts are there? There are 4 equal parts in each figure. One part is shaded in each figure. Dear student, the one part is shaded in each figure. Okay, the shaded part is called what? The shaded part is called 1/4. 1/4. The shaded part is called 1/4. How it is written in fraction? It is written as 1/4. It is written as 1/4 and read as 1/4. And what is the another way? 1/4. 1/4. Dear student, both are same. 1/4 and 1/4 both are same. They having it two names. 1/4 is nothing but a 1/4. 1/4 is nothing but a 1/4. Okay. 1/4. second, and then come to the second one. How many equal parts are there? There are 4 equal parts are there. How many parts you can share? You can only share one part. So it is a 1/4 or 1/4 or 1/4. Okay. This is the sharing method or learning method of the fraction 1/4. Okay. Then I give the one more question for the sharing of the 1/4. Okay. I draw the some figures. Okay. This can be divided into 4 equal parts. Fraction 3/4. I draw the some figures. Circle. It can be divided into again 4 equal parts. Okay. Is one of the rectangle. It can also be divided into 4 equal parts. Dear student, each figure, what you observe? Each figure having a 4 equal parts. So, you get the fraction 3/4. How many parts you can shade it? You can shade it 3 parts. Dear students, the 4 equal parts are there. You can shade it 3 parts. First part, second part, third part. Okay, it is also having 4 equal parts, you can shade 3 parts. Okay, dear student, each figure have 4 equal parts. differentiated parts are called three-fourths. Dear student, the each figure having it in four equal parts. In four equal parts, three parts are shaded. The shaded three parts we call it as a three-fourth. It is written as three-part-four. And read as one figure. This is another figure. Here, student, these two figures also having a four equal parts. You can shade it to represent 3-4. How many parts you can shade it? You can shade it 3 parts. Okay. So, four equal parts are there. You can shade it 3 parts. So, it is a 3-4. Then come to the second one. It is also having a four equal parts. You can shade it 3 parts. So, four equal parts are there. You can shade it 3 parts. Is also called as a 3-4. Okay. Dear students, in this class we discuss about the fraction 1 by 2. It is called as a 1 half, 1 quarter, 1 by 4 and 3-4. These three are called as a fraction. 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 3 by 4 are all called as fractions. Okay, your student, today class we learn about 1 by 2, nothing but a half, 1 by 4.